Obviously, there's no shortage of sun in the state of Arizona, and that leaves many homeowners wondering, are solar panels a good idea? There is a tool, and we put this tool on our blog. This tool helps you understand the financial implications of solar. Is it really gonna help your electric bill or not? So check out the tool that we've put on our blog over at stewardship.pro/blog, and then you can just search solar panels. And there again, you can put in your information to see if the savings on your electric bill is gonna help you financially. The real thing I wanna talk about for this particular video is the things that most homeowners don't think about when obtaining solar panels. There's typically two options whenever you're getting solar panels. You can either purchase solar panels or you can lease them. And most people choose to lease them, and it makes sense for a lot of different reasons. It costs a lot less money upfront. And then also whenever you lease them, they're not your solar panels, they're the actual solar companies. So as a result, they're responsible for a lot of the upkeep and maintenance and just making sure they're working overall. So a lot choose to lease. There's one big problem with that. When you lease a solar panel, that lease, that solar company is part of the chain of title of the ownership of the actual home. That's right. Whenever you lease solar panels, in most situations, there is some contractual information that ties that company and that lease with the ownership of the house that you are on as well. There's a lot of sun. Let's take this to the shade. Ah, the shade's a lot better. The chain of title basically means this. You're an owner and you have some ownership on the title of the home. And if you have a mortgage or a loan, they have a lien on that title of that home that must be paid off if anything with that title is gonna be transferred, say if you're gonna sell the property or even refinance, right? The same is true with these solar leases. They have a lien on the title of the home, and that lien must be taken care of if you choose to sell the home or if you choose to refinance. Here's the bottom line. A solar lease can dramatically complicate things when you try to sell your home or when you try to refinance your home loan. The action steps that can create this complication are typically things like getting permission from the solar lease company by having a subordination agreement, extra work from the title company to make the transaction happen, extra work and approval from the home loan lender, or extra work or approval from the seller or the buyer of the particular home. And most people don't think about this stuff prior to agreeing to having solar panels on their home. I guess the bottom line is this: solar panels can dramatically impact how you're able to make movements on that home in the future, whether it be selling or refinancing. In addition, solar panels don't always provide for you the savings on your electric bill that you might think. So head on over to our blog, stewardship.pro/blog, and search solar panels, and we'll have at the top of that blog this link that helps you understand the financial implications.